This motor claims to have 300% motive power. Is it really any better? I'll compare it with another motor. First, I'll compare the RPMs at two different voltages, and then I'll compare the stall voltage as they push a gear train. Then I'll take it apart and compare the internals to a broken Lego motor that I've got laying around. See if we can find any differences. So for the torque test, I'm slowly lowering the voltage until the motor stalls on the resistance of all these gears here. Well, it's not looking good for the GoBrick. At best, 77% of the RPMs that the Lego motor's putting out, and it's requiring 141% the voltage in order to not stall on those gears. I'm going to take it apart now and see if I can identify any difference in the internals. Everything seems to be basically the same, except that the bottom layer of Lego gears inside of the motor appear to have two different sorts of plastic making it up. So there's probably ABS on the outside and PTFE on the inside to reduce friction. So that seems to be helping it out a little bit. But I switched the gears into the GoBrick's motor and it did improve a little bit, but nowhere close to these results that we got for the Lego motor. So I think that the motor itself, the electric motor in here, is not as good of a quality motor as the one in the Lego. Now, just to be completely upfront about everything here, this actually isn't a Lego motor. This is a different generic motor that I got from AliExpress, but I did test it against Lego motors and it performed exactly the same. I also have found out that these motors don't have any thermal protection. The GoBrick's motor did have thermal protection. That's what this thing is. It's a thermistor, so as it gets hot, it will start to resist electricity and stop flow to the motor. Well, thanks for watching.